Hello everyone, welcome to the online video lectures on project management course. Now today's topic is, as you know, we are discussing the unit 5, human resource management plan. We had already discussed the first process of the human resource management plan, that is develop the human resource management plan. Okay, developing the human resource management plan. In that we have already discussed that how to identify and then how to document the roles and responsibilities of each and everyone who is involved in the project, the resources, the people involved in the project. We have to identify the roles and responsibility of all those people or individuals. Now the second process is acquiring the project team. Now this process gives us people. We start with requirement and we end with by getting people assigned to our project, because in this process we acquire the human resources, in this process we acquire the project team, in this process we acquire the people, we get the people. Okay, so we will see the input and the process of acquiring the human resource for project. It means we will see what are the inputs we need to acquire the human resource and what is the process how to acquire this human resource for project. So before acquiring, we need to know the requirements of the project, the need of the project, and we get need for the human resource, and these things we get from our human resource management plan. So this is the first input to this process. This input, that a human resource management plan, tells us how, when and what type of skills we need in a project. Now the second input, now after this, the second input is organizational process assets. What this tells us, or from this input what we get, this assets talks about the procedure for example, they talks about the procedure for hiring the people, the time periods for publishing the vacancies. This all come from the organizational process assets. These are some basic inputs are required for acquiring the human resource for project. Now we will see the tools and techniques. The tools and techniques, here we are using the tools and techniques to find a way to get the people. Why we are using the tools and techniques? So that we can get the process, we can know how to find the people, we get a way to find the people. Okay, because at the end we need people, we have to acquire people, okay, for our project. So because at the end of this process we should have people ready to join our project. Okay, so this section addresses the important topics related to acquiring the project team. The sections are, we can say that these are some tools and techniques were used to acquire the project team. The resource assignment, resource loading, and the next last one is resource leveling. Now resource assignment, it is nothing but assign people to a project. In short, we can say that resource assignment means, resource means what? The people. So it is nothing but assigning a people to our project. So the project manager must work with the other people in their organization and then assign the employee to their projects or acquire the additional human resource needed to staff the project. That the project manager have to work with the employees, have to work with the people and their organization, and then assign the employees to their project, or they can acquire the additional remote resources if needed for their project. Then he or she can assign the additional human resource needed for the project. So the we can say that also the organization must make sure that the people are assigned to the project that best fit their skills and the needs of the organizations. Whatever people you are assigning to a project, that should best fit their skills and the needs of the organization. So the output of this process is the project staff assignment, the resource availability information, and updates to the staffing management plan. These are outputs of the resource assignment process. An important component of staffing plan is maintaining a complete and accurate inventory of employees' skill. This is an important component of staffing plan, that they should maintain a complete and accurate inventory of all the employee skills, so that whenever required, they can go through those inventory and can assign the people or can acquire the people and they can find the skills needed to their projects. Okay, for example, if there is a mismatch between the current mix of the people skills and the needs of the organization, the needs of the organization are different and the current skill of the people are different. So it is the task of the project manager that they have to work with the top management and the human resource managers and also to the other peoples in the organization and address the staffing and training needs. Get it? For example, if there is a mismatch between the people skill and the needs of the organization, then in such a cases, it's a task of the project manager that they should work with the top management, the human resource manager, and also they have to work with the other people and address the staffing and training needs. Okay, so it is also important to have the good procedures in a place for hiring the subcontractors and recruiting the new employees. The project manager should have some good procedures so that using those procedures, he or she can hire the subcontractors or he or she can recruit the new employees. So the one approach to hiring and retaining the IT staff is to offer the existing employees incentives for helping recruit and retain the personnel. They can ask the employees, the existing employees, that help to please give the help or please do help give the help and recruit and retain the employee. It is very important to consider the needs of the individual and the organizations when making recruiting and retention decision. So this is about the resource assignment. Resource means what? People. So in short, it is nothing but assigning the people to the project, assigning the people to the task or to the project, to develop the project. So assign the people to project means resource assignment, and here the project manager have to work with their people, how to work with their employees, work with the organization, have to work with the top management team, have to decide some procedures, how to recruit the new employees, have to decide some procedures, how to train the employees, and so on. Now the next tool and technique is resource loading. Okay, so one of the problem or in scheduling process, we will discuss one problem from the previous topic, that is time management, where we have go through how to do the scheduling, how to prepare the schedule plan. So there is a problem with the scheduling process that they often do not address the issues of resource utilization and availability. They just give the time slot that this work requires this much time, this work requires this much time. So they never go through or they never address the issues of the resource utilization and availability. Means what? They never address the issues of the people utilization and availability. They never think about that this much amount of people we have, this much amount of employees we have or not. So they never address such issues. So the schedule tends to focus primarily on time rather than the time and resources. They actually focus on the time rather than resources, so which includes the people. So an important measure of the project manager's success is how well he or she balance the trade-offs among the performance, time and cost. This is one of the measure of the project manager's success. When he balances the trade-offs between the performance, time and cost, then we can say that he is a good project manager, or he can successfully develop the project if the project manager balances the trade-offs between these three constraints: performance, time and cost. Now we will discuss the goal. Means what the project. Now here we can say that the goal of the project manager is to achieve the project success without increasing the cost or a time required to complete the project. And the key to accomplishing this goal is effectively managing the human resources on the project. This is the important thing in this technique. This is the important thing you have to understand in this technique, that resource loading. As you know, we face the problem in scheduling process, that scheduling process is primarily focused on time and they never addresses the issues related to the resources like people. So here the goal is what? To achieve the project success without increasing the cost, without increasing the time required to complete that project. Now this, how to accomplish this goal? The key to accomplish this goal is that the project manager have to effectively manage the human resources on the project. They have to effectively this means the resource loading. Okay, that people, they have to equally assign the people to all the work activities. Okay, then and then only he can complete the project within a time, without increasing the time or without increasing the cost. So now once the people are assigned to project, two techniques are available to project manager that help them to use the project staff most effectively. Now what are those two techniques used by the project manager so that they can effectively use their project staff? The resource loading and resource leveling. These are the two techniques. Now what is resource loading? Resource loading refers to the amount of individual resources an existing project schedule requires during specific time periods. Means what? How much amount of individual resources we have, they have to go through this, and then they have to assign to those resources to the project schedule requires during the specific time periods. The resource loading helps the project manager to understand the demand of the project on the organization's resources and on individual people's schedule. They have to balance between the organizational resources and on the individual people's schedule. They have to check the people's schedule, and they have to check the project needs also, and they have to check the organizational resources also, and they have to balance between these things. Okay, project manager often use the histograms so that the project manager to understand the demands of the projects on the organizational resource and on the people's schedule. So resource histogram shows the resource loading. Okay, I show you one example. Okay, so resource loading histogram, resource histogram, they are using the resource histogram to show the resource loading period by period. So histogram can be very helpful in determining the staffing needs or in identifying the staffing problems. Now the resource histogram is used when the work is being over allocated. When they use the resource histogram, mostly the project managers are using the resource histogram in resource loading. Okay, resource loading means what? They have to equally distribute the resources. They have to equally assign the work to the resources in the project. Okay, whatever the individuals they have in the projects, they have to assign the task to them equally. Okay, They have to, this is a resource loading. So the resource histogram is used when the work is being overallocated to a certain person or group. Means what? This concept is called the overallocation. So overallocation means that not enough resources are available to perform the assigned work during a given time period. For example, for 1 month you are assigning one work and you have only two or three resources or two or three persons to work on that. So it is we call it as the over allocation. Means what? We don't have enough resources, we don't have enough employees, we don't have enough people to perform that particular task, to perform the assigned work during that particular time, means over allocation. And this is shown by the resource histogram process or resource histogram technique. Get it? The over allocation is nothing but the enough processes are not enough, means that the not enough resources are available to perform the assigned work during a given time period. This is about the resource loading. Now the next technique is resource leveling. Resource leveling is a technique for resolving the resource conflicts by delaying tasks. It is a form of network analysis. As we see, as you can visualize that the resource loading, the problem with the resource loading, that over allocation problem, that you are allocating a more work to a resources, and for that we don't have enough resources to complete that work, the assigned work in a given period or in a given time period. So resource leveling is a technique. This technique is used to resolve the resource conflicts. Okay, that the resource conflicts means what? We don't have enough resources. Okay, so the main purpose of resource leveling is to create a smoother distribution of resource usage, and reduce the over allocation. They have to reduce the over allocation. This is a main purpose, that equally they have to distribute the resources to the work. So the project manager use the network analysis techniques. Here the project manager are using the network analysis technique. They examine the network diagram, which we already discussed in a critical path method, how they analyze the critical activities, how they calculate the project time, completion time. So for that we are preparing a network diagram. So here, to overcome the to reduce the over allocation problem, to create a smoother distribution of resources, the manager uses the network analysis technique and they examine the network diagrams and for areas of the slack or float. Means what? As you know, the slack or float means what? The activity can be delayed without delaying the project, the whole project. It means what? That particular activity, that particular work can have the flexible amount of time that they can be delayed. They can be delay their work. Okay, so this is a slack time. And then the project manager identify the resource conflicts. Okay, for example, sometimes to remove the over allocation by delaying the non-critical task. Okay, or sometimes you will need to delay the project completion date to reduce or remove the over allocation. These are some examples of to remove the over allocation, to create a smoother distribution of the resource usage. As we know, the over allocation is one type of resource conflict. If a certain resources is over allocated, the task of the project manager is he can change the schedule to remove the resource over allocation. They can change the schedule and they can remove, he or she can remove the resource allocation. If a certain resources, for example, if a certain resources means the people are under allocated, the project manager can change their schedule and try to improve the use of those resources. Get it? How they can remove the over allocation? This is one method. For example, that if there is a resource is over allocated, then The project manager have the authority to change the schedule of some resources. Means what? If the resources are some resources are under allocated, then the project manager can change the schedule to try to improve the use of that resources. The resource leveling is therefore aims to minimize the period by period variations in resource loading by shifting the task within the slack allowances. It means the resource leveling. Here I already discussed this slide, that the project manager examine the network diagram, remove the overallocation by dealing the non-critical task. Resource leveling is aims to minimize the period by period variations in resource loading by shifting the task within their slack allowances. Now this is one example of resource leveling example. The resource leveling example. So this example, this is a network diagram. So at the top of this figure, it shows that the activity A, B and C. The activity A, B and C all starts at the same time. The A has a duration of 2 days and will take the 2 people to complete. The B has the duration of the activity B has the duration of 5 days and will take the 4 people to complete. And the activity C has the duration of 3 days and will take the 2 people to complete. So the histogram in the lower left corner, you can see in this figure, they shows the resource usage if all the activities start on day 1. The histogram in the lower right corner shows the resource usage if the activity C is delayed 2 days. Its total slack allowances means what? The C can be delayed because it has that flexibility, that its slack time is 2 days. It can be delayed for 2 days because the B required the 5 days. Unless and until the B completes, we cannot say that the whole project gets complete. So anyhow, C has to wait for the 2 days. C has to wait to complete, wait for the activity B. So the C have the 2 days time. So C is delayed 2 days. So it's total slack allowances. So you can notice that lower right histogram is a flat or leveled. That is, its activities are arranged to take up the least space. They are saving the days and number of workers. So resource leveling has the several benefits. These are the benefits of the resource leveling. The first one is, when the resources are used on a more constant basis, they require less management. Second one, the resource leveling may enable the project managers to use a just-in-time inventory type of policy for subcontractors or other expensive resources. And the last one is, the resource leveling results in fewer problems for project personnel and accounting departments. So these are the 3 techniques you can use for acquiring the project team. So project team, in summary, we can say that acquire the project team gives us people, gives us resources. Resources means what? People who would be working on our project. The people, we can acquire the people, we can get the people, and those people we can use for working on our project. So in summary, we can say these things. Okay, so the inputs are human resource management plan, organizational process assets, and tool and techniques are resource assignment, resource loading, and resource leveling. So acquire the project team is nothing but a process of confirming the human resource availability and obtaining the team necessary to complete the project activities. The key benefits of this process consist of outlining and guiding the team selection and responsibility assignment to obtain a successful team, and this belongs to the execution of the process group. This is about the acquiring the project team. Thank you.